VoxWave now features a streaming radio media player on our website's front page, where local artists can get their music played 24/7. For more information on getting your music in rotation or to perform live at our studio, contact Reg Gaskins at 240-832-4455.
Android users, the VoxWave app is now available in the Google Play Store. Download the app today on your Android device to listen in and view programs.
Business owners, looking for a place to advertise your business and promote your products and services? VoxWave is the right place. We have over 10,000 views a day and 70,000 listeners a month. For more information, contact Reg Gaskins at 240-832-4455.
Vox Radio, along with Then Sings My Soul Productions, is pleased to announce Wyomi Paris's Then Sings My Soul musical. The TSMS group is seeking support in our movement concerning domestic violence. This soul-stirring stage production is not to entertain, but to educate, encourage, and help eradicate this horrible disease that's plaguing women, men, and children who are affected daily in households across the world. Please join us in supporting 3-year-old Skylar Johnson's scholarship fund. Skylar's grandmother was murdered by her fiancé, then leaving Skylar's mother at age 3 to be raised by her uncle and maternal grandmother. To make your tax-deductible donation to a Skylar Johnson Scholarship Fund and for ticket information on Then Sings My Soul stage play in Brooklyn, New York on May 5th and 6th, visit thensingsmysoul.org. That's www.thensingsmysoul.org. Vox Radio, along with Then Sings My Soul Productions, is pleased to announce Wyomi Paris's Then Sings My Soul musical. The TSMS group is seeking support in our movement concerning domestic violence. This soul-stirring stage production is not to entertain, but to educate, encourage, and help eradicate this horrible disease that's plaguing women, men, and children who are affected daily in households across the world. Please join us in supporting 3-year-old Skylar Johnson Scholarship Fund. Skylar's grandmother was murdered by her fiance, then leaving Skylar's mother at age 3 to be raised by her uncle and maternal grandmother. To make your tax-deductible donation to a Skylar Johnson Scholarship Fund and for ticket information on Then Sings My Soul stage play in Brooklyn, New York on May 5th and 6th, visit thensingsmysoul.org. That's www.thensingsmysoul.org.
Enhance your listening experience. VoxWave.com.
Check out all your favorite shows at VoxWave.com. On Mondays, we keep it moving with The Kim Show from 11 to 1 p.m. Then it's time for A Change with Sherry and Mignon, 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then, In the End We Win with Curtis, 8:15 p.m. to 9:15 p.m. On Tuesdays, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Start your afternoon with The Wealth Zone with Raymond Starks. Then it's Cooking with Flavors with Chef Flavors, 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. And treat yourself right with My Spa Bath and Body, hosted by Margaret Harris, 7 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Up next is Slick Daddy Rick, Heartbeat Congo Hour, rocking from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Then on Wednesdays, you can't miss Impact the World with Cheryl Woods, 12 noon to 2 p.m. And then from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m., we got Slick Talk with Oscar D and It's the Kid. Then from 8 to 9 p.m., we crank it up with Live Set Wednesdays, hosted by Reg Gaskins. And after that, 9:15 to 10:15 p.m., the BGKH Show with Dominion and Epic. And check out our Thursday lineup, starting with You, Math, and Me, hosted by George Randall, from 10 to 10:30 a.m. Then from 7 to 9 p.m., the 6:40 Evening Show with DJ 6:40. And on Fridays, we start out with Peace in the Morning Show with Darius A. Stan, co-host Delicate Daryl Barnes, and Queen of Sudabag, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. From 10:30 to 11:30, the Hall Street Journal with Robert Hall and co-host Clarence Sanders. And after that, you know we gotta check in with Chanel's 3 Cents, 1:30 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. Up next, from 3 to 4:30 p.m., Daryl Allen Hairston II Crime Victims Foundation Show with your host, Daryl Hairston. Then, from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m., is The Rush Hour with DJ Drew and Janique. And from 9:15 to 11:15 p.m., you can't miss Different Minds Show with Bam 640 and DJ Andre Michael. co-host Hillary Banks. Then start out your Saturday mornings with the Hill of Blues Show, hosted by Ron Jackson. After that, 9:30 to 10:30 a.m., the Hour of Power with Reverend Winters Rogers. Then, from 11 a.m. to 12 noon, it's time for Prayer, Praise, and Deliverance with Elder Thurman Gorman Jr. Four Sisters Live Talk, 12:30 to 2:30 p.m. Then every second Saturday, listen to Turning Dreams into Reality Talk Show with Tashika L. Green, 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. After that, from 3 to 4 p.m., we walk in newness 24-7 with Missionary Antoinette. And don't miss, from 4:30 to 6:30 p.m., news, ULM News and Analysis, information, sports, Black history, with your host, news anchor Roderick Carter-Willis, 4:30 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Then, from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m., it's time for DJ Rick, the CEO of Step Your Game Up, the Youth Project, co-hosted by DJ Main and DJ Lo Jefe. And then, at 7:45 to 8:45 p.m., it's time for the Fantastic Live Show with MC Fran. And starting out on Sundays, from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m., I am Dr. Sharon Show with Dr. Sharon. And every first Sunday, from 3 to 4 p.m., it's the Riri Williams Show, Fashion and Style Hour. And every third Sunday, check out the Tea Talk Show with Dr. Akita Pearson, 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. Then it's time for Real Talk 101, 6 to 8 p.m. And from 8:15 to 9:15 p.m., we're tuned into the Gospel Live TV Show with Glory Mello. Stay tuned to Vox Wave, where you can find all your favorite shows.
The world's number one streaming music station, VoxWave.com.
Welcome to the Fantastic Live Show. Ron, I wanted to make sure it was like the camera was panned out so I wasn't so, you know. Thank you. Happy birthday to me. Thank you so much. Thank you. Cinco de Mayo is an amazing day right now. And everybody, welcome to the Frantastic Live Show. I'm super nervous, so you guys might.
I'm nervous too.
My A cups are in place. You all right?
Yeah.
Got them D's, though. Them D's on that. So anyway,
wow.
Welcome to the Frantastic Live Show. I'm MC Fran. Definitely looking right here. Each and every Saturday, we are here from 7:45 to 8:45, or, you know, kind of somewhere in the middle. You know, but it's my day. I'm sorry that I'm late. I appreciate everybody for all the birthday love today, especially in Northwest DC.
Is your birthday, and I wish you many, many, many more. Oh, today is a special day, one you never had before. I'll send you flowers.
Happy birthday, birthday girl.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you, everybody. I was in Northwest D.C. Just a few hours earlier for a brunch and rooftop party with Sunny in the city of WP, the other station.
It was an
amazing time. It was dope. She had like the whole dancers. And in my former life, I was a Latin ballroom dance teacher.
Wow.
So it's just fitting that my birthday would be today. But today, as a birthday gift to myself, I invited the world's most famous. Shout out to Nonchalant sitting to the right of me.
I love Nonchalant. Okay.
I love her too. You met her at 95 at 5 o'clock. And then shout out to Enoch, the Seventh Prophet, sitting to the left of me.
I love Enoch, Seventh Prophet.
Which, you know, which is like super dope that people don't know that you and I share like heavy ties because we were in a music video together for the Resurrecting Queens.
We were.
Resurrection Queens?
Yes.
My clone must have showed up because I don't remember that.
Yeah, you definitely were.
Really?
You definitely were in it. Mm-hmm. And so it's just so crazy that we would be able to like be involved within the same thing. And obviously I was just like, well, damn. I mean, I'll drive down places on U Street and I've hosted there but don't remember it. That's sad. Next chapter of my life on my 15th anniversary of my 21st birthday, I'm hoping to remember these memories. So after everybody plastered me with drinks and champagne and stuff and Patron, which is a normal...
Today?
Yeah, it's a normal happenstance on my birthday.
I know, that's right.
I'll get my brakes fixed for free.
Wow.
I've had free inspection.
Wow.
Like, all I got to do on my birthday is push these up and be like...
So the rest of the year, you just paying for everything.
Touche.
That's all right. She made up for today.
You know what?
Inspection, Patron,
you know what?
Champagne.
All of that.
I'm going to let you have that one. I'm really learning right now, Ron knows this, as we talk in my little...
Shout out to Ron.
Shout out to my producer, Ron, as we do in my little live talk show that I am learning to get these niggas to pay for everything. Ooh. Anyway, moving forward. So it's not about me for a second. It's about you two because... Uh-huh. This is dope. And I just want to say, like, it's this weird, crazy, like, you know, Venus retrograde, Earth signy, weird thing. What's your
Cookie
sign?
Libra.
You're such a Libra. And then?
Leo.
A Leo and a Libra. Yeah. So we know that he's always going to be a problem. But, like, you know, with the Libra here, she's going to, you know, balance everything out. But with that said, like, I have worked with some amazing legends in this game, and just to know that I grew up listening to them, be able to work alongside them and tour with them has been an amazing experience, but to be able to just kind of like be amongst the spider web of the DC music culture and to be able to find my way to you two has been like just honestly... Honestly, it's just a humbling, amazing, dope thing. Like, I'm such a fan, and I don't get starstruck. But what I'm going to do is... But I am today. What I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you questions that I obviously already know the answers to. But maybe, because, you know, there's a whole new generation, obviously.
Definitely.
And I wanted to bring that up to you. My first question, because I've been dying to ask it whenever, you know, I went and saw you with the nonprofit tour, which was just... an amazing thing.
Thank you.
But you mentioned like there's mumble rap going on in the stratosphere. And instead of kind of like being, well, this shit is garbage. I mean, allegedly to some people, it's garbage. You kind of embrace it and say, I mean, these young kids and these people in the game right now, these little pump, peep, poke, poop, sorry, rest in peace, peep. But the rest of them, Uzis and whatever, are just trying to feed their families and their friends.
Right.
Right?
Right. And explore their creativity and enjoy life at the same time and be blessed to be able to be paid for something that you love to do. So, I mean, I just feel like it's room for everyone. There's room for everyone. I mean, music has gotten as large as the freaking stratosphere now. There are no limitations to your ability to get to the artists that you love, like, want to find out about. So it's no reason to hate on anybody, any other artist. Yes. But you think about it, back in the day, you know, there has always been the older generation saying, what is this that you're listening to?
Right.
So we're saying the same thing. What is this you're listening to? They were saying it, you know, when Sugar Hill Gang came out, what is this you're listening to? So don't hate on them. You know what I mean? It's room for everybody. So if that's not what you want to hear, don't listen to it.
Right.
You know, I just feel like that the opportunities for all rap music, all every MC, you know, should be embraced by radio. We shouldn't be, and now radio, you know, it's becoming somewhat, you don't want to say it, but somewhat of a dinosaur with all of the streaming and people being able to get to, you know, music however they want to get to it. So they don't have to listen to the radio and wait for their favorite song and call a thousand times and request. They don't have to, people don't have to do that. So there's room for everybody. So that's why I say, you know, don't hate on, you know, young, old, whoever, if you know, whatever you're doing, if you, whatever you're saying, I don't understand it, I don't like it, I don't have to listen to it. You know, but don't hate on it. I'm not hating on nobody, because it's a blessing to be able to get revenue from something that you love to do and travel the world and see things and then be able to give to your family and do things. So that's a blessing.
It totally, and I so, you know, agree with you. Mm-hmm. It totally kind of changed the way I looked at it, because as I get older, I'm just like that crotchety old, like, what are you doing? You know, don't talk shit about Tupac, little kid, you know,
right,
I mean?
Right.
But then it's just like everything comes full circle.
Right.
There's a lot of these people that are reaching from like our generation of music, you know, to kind of make these hits that these kids never listen to.
Right.
But it really, it hurts me when I, you know, talk about Big Punisher or Big L or any of these people, and they're like, like, it just, so it puts me in our parents and grandparents, you know, position. But just as you said, I mean, going on in the 90s, like, when you finally got, you know, to work with these producers and these artists and be in the game and have this hit record, like, that's all you ever wanted. And just like you said, to be able to travel the world and work and perform with, you know, people that you look up to or people that are just your peers, like, is an amazing experience. So right now, while it's a social media driven experience where you can be famous just, you know, off of one, off the strength of saying something,
Instagram
funny on your Instagram page, like, strike. Do you know what I mean? Even if us old fogies necessarily.
I mean, I kind of would say, like, I'm almost like Common when he said, if I don't like it, don't mean I'm hating it.
True.
You know what I'm saying? Like, when I write a rhyme, I'm mumbling to myself to see how the flow of the pattern is going to be when I write
exactly.
it. But if someone calls me today and say, hey, you want to do a track with Lil Uzi Vert? And I'm like, yeah, sure.
Right.
Because I know where I'm going to stand if I do a track with him. I know where he's going to stand when he's doing a track with him. But, you know, I don't listen to it. I hear it. I don't know what they're saying half the time. But I can't diss it because, I mean, that's what y'all do.
Mm-hmm.
I do something different. Y'all do something different.
Right.
You know, if I run up against a younger cat who's doing that similar style, then I would sit and talk to him like, why are you doing that similar style?
Right.
You know, you have to be saying something if you're going to do that style.
But do you have to be saying something in this day and age? Like, it's really a hard...
I mean, now is the time to say something.
Definitely.
Don't
please
just rap,
say something.
Right now is the time. But listen, like, Cardi B obviously has taken over from being just a normal, everyday, I guess, likable person. I'm not necessarily a fan of Cardi B's music style.
Mm-hmm.
Just because, me personally, I feel like I've heard it before.
Mm-hmm.
And... But I like Cardi B. Like,
you know,
I
love
when.
Cardi B.
You know what
Shout
the,
out to Cardi
right.
B.
Right.
Yeah,
like,
you
know, we love her, but do I have to necessarily be a fan of her music
but
just
you know
to
what
love
the thing
her?
Is, right. Like, I enjoy Cardi B. Like, I like her music because she gives you that 80s vibe. Like, she, like, no one else could have been on that Bruno Mars remix.
That's true.
But her.
I agree with that.
In my opinion. Because she brings something different to the table, and I like her hustle and her grind with it.
Right.
And you know what she's saying. You may not agree with what she's saying, but you can understand the lyrics and what she's saying and where she's trying to go at with her rhyme style.
Do we feel like her rhyme style is all hers and something that is...
I don't think none of our rhyme styles is all ours because we listen to all type of music.
Agreed.
Mm-hmm. You know, I'm And, you know, we listen to Nonchalant, you know, until this day. We listen to that. But if you, as a female, you maybe, you know, pick up the pattern that she's doing, but eventually you're going to have your own style.
Right.
So we all take from somebody to create our own little way.
Do you feel like the Cardi B's and these type of people are going to be here? I mean, it's obviously not maybe something that's like a classic record we're all going to go back and listen to, you know? Mm-hmm. Are we really going to go back to like listening to Finesse or whatever, like, you know, 15, 10 years from now, like we are with like, say, 5 o'clock? Probably not.
I don't know. I mean, the thing about music is, one, what's going on in your life when a song impacts you?
Right.
Now, definitely, you know, you have timeless music, timeless records, like a 5 o'clock, that speak to you and speak to a time and speak to something that is happening, whether it be locally, nationally, internationally.
Uh-huh.
So when you have a record like that, you know, it's taking you back to, you know, the time where, you know, hustlers were on the corner and so forth and so on. You can see that. That's the thing that separates storytellers and people that make records, let's say just party records.
Right.
But that's not to lessen the impact on a party record. Because let's say you heard a particular Cardi B record when you met your boyfriend and you all ended up getting married, and 20 years later you hear this Cardi B record. That's going to be impactful to you because that's what happened to you. So I don't want to make Cardi B's or anybody's music, anybody's music, you know, to say it's not going to be timeless to someone. But at the same time, records are timeless for different reasons. Yes, you have records that you don't have to hear ever again. Yes, we do have those.
Right.
But then, like, I just played the other night, well, as a matter of fact, yesterday, Ice Ice Baby, Vanilla Ice, Ice Ice Baby. Now, was that one of my favorite songs? No, but when I hear that song, it takes me to a time. It makes me remember certain things.
Right.
You know, was he talking about something pivotal in somebody's life, blah, blah, blah? Not in my opinion,
but at the same time,
when you hear that record, it takes you to a point in your life where you something was happening.
Mm-hmm.
So that can be any song, you know. So like I said, songs are timeless and impactful for different reasons. And that's the beauty of music. And that's what makes it transcend, you know, all genres and ages and things like that. So that's why when 5 o'clock came out, I knew when I heard a 6-year-old sing the song, they had no clue as to what the song meant, but it was impactful to that 6-year-old because something moved them. So now their parent is singing it and it's impactful to them for a different reason.
Mm-hmm.
But now when 20 years later, when I have that 6-year-old who is now 26, say, I heard that song, I remember that song, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
It's not because, you know what I mean? Yeah, I knew somebody was on. No, it's because they remember the song. It was impactful to them for a different reason than their parent.
Right. And also that song was impactful to the culture because around that same time you had the Million Man March.
Very true. Okay.
You know what I mean? You had that same thing, that same vibe of everybody like, songs had to mean something, had to have some type of thing. When the riots happened in D.C., what were they playing? You know, who they was playing? James Brown.
Mm-hmm.
So these things had timeless attitudes with them. When I sit down and listen to Jay-Z's first album, Reasonable Doubt, it takes me back to college. And I'm like, this is a timeless record. Like, this whole album is dope. But when you talk to, like, Lil Uzi Vert, or any of these artists that we consider mumble rappers or whatever have you, you have to understand too that wherever this first young person heard Uzi Vert at, where was he or she at in their lives? And did this particular song or record, whether we are right or wrong, help them out of their disparity to be like, I want to do this rap thing?
That's interesting, because there people who look to Lil Uzi or Kodak or whomever to these people.
Kodak is dope, though.
I mean, I'm not taking away.
Right.
I have a couple of Kodak songs that I do like, but at the same token, like, I'm old enough to probably be his mom, and it's just like, it's this whole new generation of
She's so old today. She's super old today.
Super old today.
Speaking of, it's my birthday. Absolutely. But you know, I feel just every bit of it going into my ninth life.
God, I'm getting ready to. When I leave here, I'm just going into an old folks' home.
Stop. But there's nothing wrong with it. I love being my age. I absolutely. You don't know who you are.
Like, she's you don't. Like it's over for me.
Everybody's
the last over. Time you'll see me
I don't want to hear it out of everybody's woman crush nonchalant. Talking trash, whatever. She's everybody's WCW, so I don't even want to hear it.
That's so sweet.
It's true. So it's whatever. If I could look and be anything like you, you know, in the next year, because you're probably a year old.
You got to understand that Nonchalant was our MC Light of DC.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Okay, so before we got all into me and my
funny story, MC Light got called Nonchalant one day walking down the street in New York. Shout out to Light, man. Shout out to Light.
So
whole wealth movement.
There's so many things I want to ask you about that because I wanted to go into that because I didn't want to forget to ask you about that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because it's a big deal to me because obviously this music shit is huge to me. Mm-hmm. But at the same token, I don't want to be turning my back on somebody who may be the next whomever because I'm still really mourning the loss of our Punisher, Biggie, Tupac era. Not just necessarily these three, mm-hmm. but you know, with Queen and with you and with, you know, DeBrett and like all these people that I, you know, looked up to. It's a hard, they're big shoes to fill. Mm-hmm. And you don't think about that until you grow up. Now, my generation had these millennial children who are like the me generation, mm-hmm. and apparently, you know, drug culture, you know, mm-hmm. music and everything. And to me, mm-hmm. it's just kind of like, it's sad, but maybe if we kind of clear the minds of this new generation who are our future, they kind of are speaking. It's not just necessarily all about me. They're telling people, well, this is how I feel. This is what it is. Like, mm-hmm. listen to what I'm saying. Like, there's a generation that, like, makes you stand up and pay attention.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Does that make sense? So if maybe they kind of, like, switch their mind-altering substance into just music instead of the substances, mm-hmm. maybe they would be on par to take the next, you know, shape of the generation. Because there's nothing like 90s or the early 2000s music, but this music.
I mean, 90s ain't coming back. 2000s not coming back. Mm-mm. As brother Jay from the X-Clan said that if you're an MC, you're still stuck in the 90s, mm-hmm. then you need to sharpen your sword so you could be doper in the millennial age.
Mm-hmm. Right, mm-hmm, definitely.
That's how you kind of...
I mean, for sure.
You know, and, you know, even for the young folks that's just on the substance, it's all about... Whatever they're going through in their life, I don't know what people are going through in their life.
Right.
I can't do that because I'm not a counselor. But what I can say is that the music is a gateway out of what they're trying to do and what they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're following a leader or someone they're looking up to that's doing the same thing that they're doing, it's going to be hard for them to break that chain until someone comes along and say, all right, young brother or young sister, I may be older than you. I may be like your mom or your dad, but let's write me a rhyme that you're not cursing. Just write a rhyme that you're not cursing at all and challenge them to do it and see if they can do it. Write me a rhyme that you're not talking about popping pills or drinking or women. Write me one rhyme and let's see where we go from there.
You make such a good point.
And the reason I say that is because someone hit me on DM a couple of months ago. He was like, yo, I've been following you for a while and he's in the drug culture. Mm-hmm. He's a young dude in the drug culture, the gang culture.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sitting there like reading his whole DM and I'm like, yo, why'd you contact me?
Mm-hmm.
He was like, because I think I can learn something from you. So right then and there, it's a time to you can learn. And now we're talking. We're talking back and forth. And I see where his head at and understand, like, he's in a trap, really. But he wants to get out of that game and do something positive for himself. So I was like, this is what you do. I gave him a homework assignment. Get a crew together. Figure out what y'all want to do. Figure out your names, because your name is Little Something. I said, no. We got to have to change that little part, because mm-hmm. When you get older...
Mm-hmm.
They don't call Bow Wow Lil Bow Wow.
Right,
anymore.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, and we giving, you know, you want to give people these jewels so they can have something to live for and be productive. I mean,
well, that's an amazing thing.
I could diss all whack rappers all day, but what am I going to give them after I diss them?
Exactly. You just made a huge, huge point, and one that I wanted to make, because sometimes it's like, well, you know, fuck them, they're never, you know, this is garbage, blah, 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 but who are they going to turn to to be like the inspiration or the mentor? Because I still have mentors in this industry, and I wouldn't be where I am if I didn't have them, as coming from California and seeing gang culture and knowing that, you know, now it's like a popular thing when really it's a dangerous thing. That shit is not very cool. But as somebody who's kind of an older
person and an experienced type of person. Mm-hmm. The goal is to kind of mold and shape our future, not just turn our back on the future and say, well, sorry, you guys, you know, you suck, you fucked everything up, you're on drugs, you know, whatever. Because at the same token, every single generation had their drug. Every single, it may not have been prescription. Right. You know, every single generation had their problems.
Right, right,
you know,
exactly.
From Woodstock to, you know what I mean? So you never really know. Let's take a quick break, because I want to come back and get like deep and personal and talk about, you know, everything that happened before 1995 and who you are and this community as just leaders. Mm-hmm. And just get into the hot seat, because that's what I do. And then we'll get into the last part. We'll talk about the goings on of today and the culture and the Kanye and all this craziness. And it would mean the world to me if you would, you know, interject on that. So, Fantastic Live Show. This is an amazing special birthday edition.
Happy birthday!
Thank you.
Birthday.
We'll be right back really quick.
What a cake is, though.
Well, I know,
right?
Nobody here could buy me a cake.
Boo.
Really?
Dang.
This place, what kind of place is this?
I don't know.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, yo, you know it's going to cost you more money having me out at 5 o'clock in the morning, right?
I got your money. Don't worry about your money, man. I got your money, man. Just meet me at Benning in Minnesota, man, all right?
Benning in Minnesota? I'll be there.
What could you possibly be doing?
So what, man? You need to stop trying to be my mother and be my sister, man.
Mother or sister? You keep going out this time in the morning, something's going to happen to you. Jay. Jay. It's really real when I feel the way that I do right now. I see all my brothers underground pushing up daisies. Man, it amazes me that you can't see where you're going to be. A statistic. Everybody's gone cold ballistic. If they had a good day, damn, I must have missed it. Cause you're mad at the universe. Go to hell with everybody else. Cause you want your own purse. I got the urge to let you in on a little secret. But you keep dying if you keep it. All the killing that you're feeling is wrong within. Pull the cover, check the color of your skin. Voila. I couldn't try even if I had to. Born with the bulletproof vest when I had you. A black woman trying to get to a few. So you can lead the next group. 5 o'clock in the morning. Gonna be